It started like just another spring day on the job for a New York City exterminator.
He noticed that there were large cockroaches inside the bait station. And when he showed them to me, I knew that there were characteristics there that were something that I had not seen in this part of the country in the 30 some odd years that I've been working in the pest control industry.
The puzzling cockroach was examined by experts from Florida to Washington, D.C., before ending up at the Ware lab at Rutgers University, where researchers capture cockroaches for a different reason.
In my studies in South America, where I collect specimens and I'm trying to figure out how we characterize the biodiversity by defining species, I had the job of trying to identify the species. I do work with cockroaches on an everyday basis, but even for me, identifying cockroaches is very difficult. So that's why we had to employ the tool of using genetic identification.
Through a process called DNA barcoding, Evangelista identified the genetic information of the mysterious roach's mitochondria and produced a DNA sequence that could be compared with other known cockroach species.
We did that, we saw that the two unknown specimens fell on the same branch of the tree as the Japanese cockroach. We saw that the sequences were identical. This is a species that's not known to be invasive in the U.S. It has an interesting characteristic that it is cold tolerant, which is unique among pest cockroaches we see in New York City.
Many of these invasive species become successful because they know something or they can do something which other species cannot do. They have traits which are novel to the system, and therefore they become successful and invasive.
But the arrival of a new cold-tolerant cockroach isn't novel. The invasion has been going on for centuries. New York's famous roaches originated elsewhere. There's the Oriental cockroach, actually thought to be from Africa, which likes wet and damp areas. The American cockroach, also of African descent, which is partial to sewer lines and floor drains. The German cockroach, a Southeast Asian export, which you may find in your kitchen. The brown banded cockroach, native to Africa, which likes drier parts of your home like your bedroom. And the Suriname cockroach of Southeast Asian origin, which burrows in ornamental plants.
When humans came to new areas, they brought these species with them. But since they always travel with humans, they might be one of the first species we have brought into North America. I'm quite sure that Jamestown, for instance, had cockroaches. We stepped from a ship, something else came as well.
In fact, John Smith, one of the founders of Jamestown, wrote in 1624 that a certain India bug, called by the Spaniards a cockroach, that which creeping into chests they eat and defile with their ill-scented dung. But the pest cockroaches we've grown all too familiar with make up just a small percentage of cockroach species.
About less than 1% of the cockroaches that exist on the planet are pest species. We know about 4,500 species, but there's probably a lot more than that. The only formal estimate that I've seen is about 20,000. They're cockroaches with some amazing qualities. There are other cockroaches that glow in the dark. There are other cockroaches that have bright metallic coloration. There's a huge variety of awesome behaviors that they display.
Cold tolerance is just another trick in their time-tested arsenal.
Well, they've always said that cockroaches will be the last living thing found here. You know, if you look back in the historical record, cockroaches have not changed that much in 350 million years. So it's pretty much a perfect living thing. They'll be here long after we're gone.
Thanks for watching. And if you like this video, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment.